Alright guys, haven't exactly been doing a whole lot of recording of this, been kind of busy doing the inlay work, but figured I'd better get at least a short video in. These are not real thick sheets of brass, but more along the lines of the thickness of the blade, a little bit thinner. Makes a lot of brass powder. It's right in a jar. Put it down as close as I can. Scraping the heck out of the wood. This done, I've got to scrape out some of the epoxy and fill in where it got a little bit too thin on the wire. Replace the wire. It wasn't that thick to begin with. Underestimated the depth I needed to make it. Didn't take into account undulations and curvatures. Especially where I had them overlapping. So it kind of spirals off in little thin strips, like this one here. It was a thick wire. Maybe I should have made it a lot deeper. I've been able to take out some of these marks from where the fret slots were next to the ones that I ended up making for these in an accurate position. But as Ben Crow's fond of saying, making mistakes a feature. So it will be. Might have this thing assembled and playable before I do those modifications, but I will be doing them. I have a feeling this is an instrument I'm going to keep adding inlay and detail to for the foreseeable future. I haven't gotten in the alphabetic stamps to do some stamping. Might end up sacrificing a kit and using it for burning. Problem with not doing these one at a time but you end up with a risk to your knuckles, the one next to it. Like this one I put in and then filed before I did anything else. Mainly to save the end of the fretboard from chipping off. I have also considered putting in essentially like you would a ramp of some Purple Heart down the end between where the pickup will be and the end of the fretboard. Basically like a fretboard extension sort of kind of. We'll see. It's not like I don't have plenty of, you know, Purple Heart and such sitting around here. Although, the Duke would look really interesting. We have some of that in the drawer here. Keep the green going this way. I don't think I have a piece wide enough. Distracted by details. Anyway, this is basically a lot of filing after using saws to make the slots, cleaning them out with the saw, piece of the brass, whatever. Get the dust out, gluing them in, dialing them down. In the case of these here, these were the, not the thin pieces of material, but the wider ones that are essentially big enough to make two. So, did two, did another two. Shaving there. And I think around the wires, I'm going to clean out or edge around it and use brass powder to fill in the edges. Make them pop a little bit more. And adding more work. And if you can listen very carefully, you may not pick up on this microphone. That high pitch, if you're going across the metal, you start getting into the lower tones when you start rasping across some wood, or filing across some wood. When you're there pretty quickly. Always best to angle down your edges, your ends, as you're going. Doesn't make as dramatic a chatter on them. You've already got them started. Limited experience. All right. some of that pile. Use a piece of the brass as a shovel. Don't have to get all of it. Throw some of it out. Although, there's still a lot right there. There's a lot of sawdust in there. Let's do this. Get this. And I'm going to clean this mess up so I can get some of this purple heart out of the way so it doesn't mix. Okay. Trying to keep it as flat as possible. Pushing too hard is how I'm getting these strips. Go through and sharpen a lot of my cutting tools. These are not cutting as well as they used to. And shears, I had to try and sharpen those, but really for this thin sheets, they are not very effective. I need to make a wild mess. The aviation shears I have would work, but they bend it all up. Oh, dang it. Getting the wood again. Alright. Close. I go through and sand this anyway, so I'm not too worried about any minor little scratches. Got it to 220, and then I went and filed across it. Give myself more work and all, but it was unfortunately necessary to do it this way. Couldn't have it too rough. Wouldn't be able to find level. And I don't have the intermediate sandpaper handy. Didn't have what I thought I had. Inventory control is a good thing. So you know what you have and what you don't. It's pretty darn close. Finally clean up here and there. Tried to make sure before I went to bed the other night to take off the sharp edge on this side. For the most part. More of a safety thing. And I'm beating the heck out of the side of my keyboard. Okay, don't do that. There we go. Clean up on that side. I want to get to that point. Anyway, you get the idea. Problem with having channels pre-cut on these side channels was that when I went to go pour the epoxy, or in this case, super glue, it flows into it. Fills up channels that you aren't ready for yet. In this case, it wasn't that big of a loss because I'm going to have to make them deeper anyway. Just a little added work to get these out of the way so I can get in there. Get the wood widened down or deepened. A little bit of added removal of super glue out of the groove. And get some of the wood down there. Okay. Is going to change anyway when I go through here with the Dremel. I'm just trying to not gum up the Dremel as much as possible. Little micro scraper. Edge of the wire with the blade. Come back over, it'll cut the cut. Go back to the side groove, do the same thing. Cut the cut. Having the advantage of being semi-ambidextrous, I can go through and do it this way. Don't recommend to do it this way if you are not that coordinated with your left hand. It can result in some rather nasty cuts in you as well, but in the wood. Tiny motions. To cut deep in the hole. This out of here before I put too much of the dust in it. A little contamination, I don't mind. I don't do any chemical experiments with this. Chemistry experiments with it. But don't want to make it any worse than I already have. Tiny bits of brass here. Hold down pieces. Okay. Now, found out this was copper core, hence the copper color. This one, not so much. As I can tell from these, not any copper in it. Check depth on these. Oh yeah, I think that's pretty close. Clean up a little bit here. A lot of this comes from experience, getting a feel for the material you're working with and the tools that you're using. It's somewhat training and skill, just natural skill, but there's a lot of trial and error getting used to the material you're going to be working with, because even in the same type of wood, grains vary, even in the same piece. I think I'm going for this one. Yeah. Anyway, this inlay is going to change probably good 2 or 3 more times in the process. Appearance as I add to it. I'll give you updates when I get to that point. In the meantime, let me finish this real quick, and then I am going to end this section of the video. It may be a video on its own. You'll know probably same time I do, or soon thereafter. It's got 2 branches on it, so it's going to be in pieces, obviously. Oops, not too much. Back the other way. chainmail supplies out. Tools. And bend this wire with these needle nose so I don't end up angled too much. Yeah, it's not quite right anyway. I need to start further out. I'm trying to bend wire too much because it just snaps. You're a little long this time. To be able to do that. And then there. And then this one. Again, a little long. Trying to let you guys see this as it's being done. So you get an idea of how I'm doing this. Sharpens. No, that one's fairly sharp. Alright, now. That. There. Again, this is more of a modify as you go, straighten up things as you can to get it where you want it for the look that you're looking for. It's still on. Too short, but they're too long because of those catches and filing or sanding. Oops, gotta straighten that back up. Out of the hole. Here, flat out. Okay. It's messing with me. I'm gonna have to do this. Thank you.
too much now. Come on. Okay, that was pretty close.
They have to be pretty and beautiful and all that, but the bottom of the hole just has to be usable. And I'm not looking for a perfectly straight line on these. They are vines after all. Okay. So I want to go out to that point there. Overshoot like that. Cut to cut. Deep enough. Cut to cut. Play the part of a phlebotomist. I'm not here to draw my own blood. Trying to cheat and end up doing scratches. Going down flat. Now that's sticking up. What did I just do? Dent it somewhere. Free a little wire. Let's go cockeyed on you when you look at it sideways. Yeah. still sticking up quite a lot over here. I need it. Myself in the process. There we go. Hold this flat. Slightly bend that. Eyeball it a tad bit more. Anyway. Eyeball it. And check. Putting marks in my wire, but somewhat obeying me now. Right there. All right, now it's just sticking them in all kinds of ways. Play with it, manipulate it, a little here, a little there. All right, looks like I'm fairly flat. Tap that. Now I'm dinging my no better than that. Right. It will work, but I'm going to make it a little bit deeper. Just so I know when I go to file and sand, I'm not going to file into it as much as I did last time. I'm using a scalpel blade as a pick. Not the safest thing to do. And doing this is probably a good idea if I were wearing safety glasses. But I'm having enough trouble seeing where I'm going without them. Too many shadows on this. It's better. Whew, running right now. Still, never ceases to amaze me how much I sweat when I'm doing these little straining movements. I'm tensing more of my muscles than I think I am. Yeah, so my shoulders pop. I've definitely been straining. It's not how you hold the tongue, it's how you hold your shoulders. I'm kidding, of course. Really, really hard. still bent up a little. It's still a little shallow here. Man, it's taking a lot longer than I was expecting it to. So being careful around the other inlay is taking time. You don't want to pop out these little cultured opal inlays that I did. Now that I've got them filed flush. It'd be counterproductive. Probably best to wait on those until you get near the end of doing the inlay for future reference. This is where being a dental technician would come in handy. You have lots of practice at this fiddly, tiny stuff. Big unit guitars, he was saying that he knew a guy that had dental tools that he did little detail work when he was working. I can't remember where he said he was working, but he worked with him once, and after that he said, I'm going to have to get me some of those. Those tools are really handy. I don't have those. Too wide, because then it's more I have to fill in with brass powder and such accents. Again, that hard grain right there. I think it's still sticking up a bit. Yeah, slightly angle. I think I'm deep enough to just have that one piece. Where I want to bend, then I'll push the bend. And hopefully I didn't bend it too much. Yeah, slightly so. Alright. Back the other way. Just a hair. Now this end's sticking up a bit.
surgery over here. I think that'll do. Now, here comes the fun part. Getting this down the bottom of the groove and keeping it there while you flood it with a little bit of super glue. Some of the stuff likes to float, others doesn't. Always put your cap on your super glue, people. If you're going to be pounding on this stuff, make sure you're wearing safety glasses. Especially if you're doing real frets, because it tends to, the mushroom cap tends to make it splatter. You know, as a Ben Crow warned, if you ever get super glue in your eye, don't blink. Reach up with a clean finger and take it back out. I don't want to ask how I knew that. Alright. This definitely darkens the wood around it. Ah! Get down in there and stay down in there. Quit popping up. Need something else to poke down with. Something thin. So thin. There we go. It's still sticking up a bit. I do have nail polish remover right back there, so I can clean these tools up with it, but that little man I'm not worried about. It does almost have a 3D effect. It looks like it's kicking up. But look at it other ways, and it's not kicking up. How much of it is actual, how much of it is not. I know, I'm cheating. I'm going to do this fairly quickly because super glue does set a lot faster than epoxy. I only have a great deal of experience with the epoxy, but it does set faster. I can always go back and put a little bit more epoxy, a little more. The super glue on this. That's probably a lot more than I need. Yeah, we don't have lots of it, but no sense wasting. Too gaudy. It's gaudy, not gaudy, like, you know, the mobster. Do you like some of that detailed art from India, filigree and decorations of all kinds of powders and such, essentially expensive glitter and glitter. But that'll give you a basic idea on how that's done. Of course, you just file off the excess of the epoxy and hope they don't take too much glitter with it. And in the case of where the frets are going, let's go back through, clean up with a saw, pop your brass pieces in. That looks like it needs to be filed more, just a little mushroomed. It's so fine that you almost won't see it, except when the light catches it. Not quite as visible as I would like. But I didn't want to use a really thick brass either. Risk splitting the wood. It really sucked to get all the way through and then put those in and end up cracking off major sections or cutting it in half by pounding in the brass. Yeah, all kinds of brass filings down in here. Mm-hmm. Some wood dust and sawdust as well. Alright, I'll just let that go out of this wood sawdust. Clean it out. Here, I'll show you how I do it. Thinner saw. Set I gotta go to church. Well, I don't have to. I want to go to church. One of the joys of being in revival. And no, I don't mean revival meetings. I mean power of God. Highly recommended.